Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy, doing the final exam review today. This is a review from chapter one. Quite a few things to get through, so I don't want to make this any longer than it has to be. I started this and made a typo, so I started over. 5 minus 10 is negative 5 squared is how I got 25. 2 minus 6 is negative 4, and the absolute value of negative 4 is 4, but I still have negative 2 times that. Then I did the exponent down below, 2 squared is 4. The next thing I'm going to do is on the top I get 25 minus 8, and on the bottom I have multiply and divide. Be careful because you want to do that division before you do the multiplication because you go left to right. 120 divided by 5 is 24, and then times 4. 25 minus 8 is 17. And 24 times 4 is, I don't know, 80, 96. Yep, 96. And if you could simplify 17 over 96, you would. I put that in my calculator quickly and see that it does not simplify. That one I'm just pointing out, you always do division before multiplication if it comes first from left to right. On the second one, 3 to the third power is 27. Inside the parentheses, we have subtraction and division. We're going to do that subtraction first. 10 divided by 2 is 5. And here, people sometimes want to get 27 minus 3 first, but we have to finish the parentheses and multiply by 3 before we do that. 5 minus 5 is 0. 27 minus 0 is 27. And this one has a little more punch to it. We're going to do what's inside the parentheses before we do anything outside, so we're not going to subtract those. Negative 3 times 6 is negative 18 plus 2, and negative 3 times negative 3 is negative 9 plus 3. And I don't know. Negative 18 plus 2 is negative 16. Negative 9 plus 3 is negative 6. I know that I can simplify. Two negatives make a positive, and I actually get 8 thirds. And then I'm going to multiply these. 6 minus 56 thirds. I can do that last bit on a calculator. 18 minus 56. Well, you can use your calculator to do it. I was kind of doing it half in my head, but you can just do 6 minus 56 over 3, and that gives you negative 38 thirds. The big thing I'm trying to warn you about here is you want to completely simplify inside the parentheses first, then multiply by the number out here, and then finally do that subtraction. The other thing that's sort of challenging for students in this chapter is the negative exponents. We're going to simplify some expressions that have negative exponents in them. First of all, when you see a problem like number 4, you're going to think of that as the numbers, and then the A's, and then the B's. The numbers are easy because negative 86 over 42, you can just put it in your calculator and simplify that, or you can divide by the common denominator, however you want to do it. But it's going to be negative 43 over 21. They have a common factor of 2. And then what happens to these variables? Well, if they have a exponent that's negative, they've got to change places in the fraction so that a to the negative 3 goes down and a to the negative 7 goes up. And when they change places, then they become positive. And then I'm just going to write these down for now. Now I need to simplify. Well, I've got negative 43 over 21. Well, where do I have more a's? I have more a's on top by how many you're actually subtracting. You get a to the fourth. And where do I have more b's? I have more b's in the denominator. How many actually subtract? 13 minus 4, and you get 9, and there's 9 extras in the denominator. So that's what your answer would look like. For the next one, I'm going to distribute the power to every part of the fraction. I've got 3 to the fifth and x to the fifth and y to the 2 times 5 or y to the 10th. I'm going to just go ahead and put these together. Negative 2 to the negative 1. I've got x to the negative 3 times negative 1, that's positive 3. And I have y to the 3 times negative 1, or negative 3rd. All right, so negative 2 to the negative 1, well, let's do it this way. Anything that's got a negative power needs to move. Okay, and so I still have 3 to the 5th on the top. I still have x to the 5th on the top. I still have x to the 3rd on the top. I now have y to the 3rd on the top. I now have negative 2 to the 1st power, which I don't need to write that, but just so you can see. And I still have y to the 10th on the bottom. So anything that had a positive power, I did not move. Anything that had a negative power, I did. And now I'm just going to clean this up. 3 to the 5th power, I can write that. If it was paper, I wouldn't care, but I think the computer likes you to do that. So that's going to be 243 over negative 2. X to the 5 plus 3 is x to the 8th. And where do you have more y's? You have more y's on the denominator. Subtract, and you get y equals 7. Those are in the denominator, because that's where I have more. And this one, I'm going to do the same kind of thing. I have 3 to the 5th. I have x to the negative 15th. I have another 3. I have another x squared. And I have x to the negative 4th. Anything that's got a negative has to move. X to the negative 15th goes down. X to the negative 4th goes up. Remember, this is like 3 to the 1st power, so I have 5 plus 1 more, or 3 to the 2nd power, or 6 power, 5 plus 1 is 6. I still have an x squared on top, that was there, and now I have an x to the 4th on top, and now I have an x to the 15th down below. And so that looks like 3 to the 6th power, x to the 6th power over x to the 15th. 3 to the 6th power is 729. And where do I have more x's? Well, I have more x's down below, so that's where they're going to be left over. 15 minus 6 is 9, so I have x to the 9th, sorry, on the bottom. I did not write that very nicely. So I have 729 over x to the 9th power for that one. That one can be a little challenging. Those little things can be challenging. The other two things that I want to show you are a scientific notation and then your variable. Scientific notation, you can do it on your calculator. You can also do it on paper very easily. I'll show you both. So it's nice to be able to check it on your calculator, I think. If your teacher is asking you to show work, you can do it on your calculator just to check. What you can do here is multiply the numbers, and then you have your bases. Your tens, you're going to add those powers together. So we get 4.2 times 3.1 is 13.02. And then we keep the base the same. We add our powers. That's going to be negative 40. But notice that this is not between 0 and 1, so I need to move the decimal point over one place. Well, I was going to go 40 places to the right, and I took one of those steps and moved it over, so now I only have 39 places to go. I stepped in the direction I wanted to go anyway. What would that look like on the calculator? Well, there's a nice button on your calculator. If you have my calculator, it's EE. Sometimes it's just a capital E. What would I do if I did 4.2E? And then that's negative 15 times 3.1 EE, which just shows up as an E, but I was pushing that EE button, and then negative 25, and that gives me 1.302 times to the 39th power. You still have to write it in the correct format, because this calculator leaves out the 10, but it tells you what the exponent's going to be, and it tells you what the number is. Isn't that sweet? Okay, let's try it on this one. If I did 3.1 to the 15th, and then divided by 9.3, whoops, I need to put my parentheses. I don't even know if I need to, but it feels good to do it. And these, whoops, I don't want to do that. I hit the wrong button. E to the negative 5, and and I get 3.333333 e to the 19th. Well, I would round that two places or one place and just have 3.3 because our problem had one significant digit there, two significant digits, one decimal place. But anyways, 3.1 divided by 9.3, think of this as two separate problems. And this is 1/3, so that is 0.333, however far out you go. And this is 10 to the 15th minus negative 5. So be careful, or the other way you can think about it, that negative 5 goes up and becomes positive. So that's how we started off with 0.333 times 10 to the 20th power. And now I need to go 20 places to the right. I take one of those steps, because I have to make this between 1 and 10. And when I take one step, I only have 19 left then, which is what my calculator showed me already. Okay, and then solve for the indicated variable. No calculator help on this one. You just have to know what that means. It means that we're trying to isolate that particular variable, and this is the one we're isolating right here. And so what we're going to do is first get rid of this t in the denominator by multiplying both sides by t. I am intentionally going fast on these videos. It could be that this isn't necessarily what you want to write down, but just a chance to review it. Then you could go back to the videos where Andrea takes a lot more time, goes a lot slower. This is a quick review, just to kind of show you what's on the final and kind of maybe take some of your anxiety away. And then we have d1 minus d2. We want to solve for d2, so we want to get rid of the d1. So I have vt minus d sub 1. Those subscripts are supposed to be there to like challenge you, because that's what you're going to see in your science classes. Oh, so this was minus d2. I can't just drop that. That's there, right? And now I need to get that by itself, so I need to divide everything by negative 1. So I have negative vt plus d sub 1 equals d sub 2, or I could say d sub 2 equals d sub 1 minus vt. Either one. Notice that the minus is in front of the vt, whichever way. So you're just multiplying by t, moving the other term, and then getting rid of the negative. And that is everything that I needed you to know about chapter 1. Have a fantastic day. We'll see you next time.